Welcome to all of you joining us from 25 countries across the world. We've got over 1,000 viewers and we're honoured to have every single one of you with us today. My name is Vandana Saxena-Poria. I am the founder of the Human Alarm Clock and I will be your GC or guider of ceremonies today. We have a power-packed summit which has been handpicked and curated by the Indo-American Chamber of Commerce in partnership with Automation Alley on Integrate Industry 4.0. So what was the need for Integrate? What is the urgency of Industry 4.0 and how can you be part of it? Well, who better to give us a formal introduction than Rajitha Jagtap, who's the chairperson of the Indo-American Chamber of Commerce here in Pune. Rajitha is a second generation entrepreneur of the globally reputed capital goods company, Sarge Test Plant Private Limited, which has a rich heritage of 52 years from our very own city of Pune. She's the first woman to become the chairperson of the prestigious Indo-American Chamber of Commerce, Pune branch, as well as being a board member of the distinguished MCCIA and vice chairperson of the British Business Group. We now look forward to the formal opening address to witness the launch of Integrate India 2021 and explain what it's all about. Over to you, Rajitha.
A very warm welcome to all of you to our very first global flagship event, Integrate India 2021. The ground reality is that businesses will not exist in the future if we don't make a shift now to Industry 4.0. Technology is moving so rapidly, causing a complete disruption in manufacturing, and new practices are evolving every single day. If we don't learn and implement them, we will not only be left behind, but become obsolete. Therefore, I'm super excited to tell you all about Integrate India 2021, which is organized by the leading business forum, the Indo-American Chamber of Commerce, in partnership with the Automation Alley of Michigan, USA. This conference will ensure that you don't just survive, but you thrive in this VUCA world. As you probably know, the three main objectives of the Indo-American Chamber of Commerce are to act as a catalyst between India and the US for sustainable growth of businesses, also promote bilateral trade through investments and technology transfers, facilitating business collaborations, joint ventures, marketing tie-ups, and strategic business alliances through a set of proactive business-oriented initiatives. Since its creation, the Indo-American Chamber of Commerce has grown to 2,400 members pan-India, which come from diverse business backgrounds and segments like manufacturing, engineering, construction, consumer goods, electronics, IT, pharmaceutical, consulting, travel and tourism, etc. Now, regarding this splendid event that we're launching today, called the Integrate India 2021, what is really the thought that went behind starting or thinking about Integrate, which inspired us to think about an event like this? It all began in 2019 when we were thinking of the significant changes, opportunities, and challenges that the industry was facing and grappling with. And also, why should it be so important for the manufacturing and IT companies predominantly? There are a few reasons for it. We all know that at the heart of Industry 4.0, technology plays a significant role. However, our view is that the ramifications of Industry 4.0 will be far-reaching in the coming years. Leading global manufacturers have already embraced these practices, and we see a multitude of technology options available in the market. And yet there are multiple questions in the minds of manufacturers like myself. To what extent would our businesses be impacted? When is the right time to make the shift? How would it really make our businesses more competitive? Is there a way to guarantee ROI on Industry 4.0 projects? How do we handle our employees in this transition? These are some of the questions, and the classic business questions that come to our mind beyond technology. So we at ICC wanted to address Industry 4.0 more holistically for the benefit of the industry. That is how the seeds of this event were sown in 2019. This conference has been organized keeping these objectives in mind. Later in Feb 2020, a delegation from Automation Alley, Michigan, USA, which is a World Economic Forum, a manufacturing hub, and a center of excellence for Industry 4.0, visited Pune and met with our ICC Pune team. When we shared our thoughts about Industry 4.0, we came to know that they were organizing a similar conference, which was a virtual one, Integrate 2020 in November. Incidentally, ICC Pune participated in that event, but more importantly, the idea of conducting an India conference was jointly discussed and got formalized at that time. Today, we are ready to launch this conference, and I'm feeling extremely proud about it. But you all must be asking yourselves, what is Industry 4.0? Industry 4.0 is a term that originated in Germany, as we all know, and it denotes the fourth industrial revolution, which aims at a connected value chain in manufacturing that is personalized, smart, and intelligent. The fourth industrial revolution is radically changing the way we work and live. The cascading impact of this revolution is that the manufacturing techniques are undergoing major and rapid shifts globally. And whether you like it or not, all of us have to make this transition. Let me explain to you what are the technological pillars on which Industry 4.0 rests. As we all know, these are some of them and there are many more, like machine-to-machine learning, 3D printing, cloud computing, Internet of Things, RFID solutions for real-time tracking of your goods, to high-level simulations to avoid any manufacturing defect. So why should we implement Industry 4.0? The clear signal today is that the world of manufacturing and digital technology are fast converging. Let us look at some of the examples. In the Western world, we see companies such as GE, Siemens, General Motors have acquired software companies to enhance their digital advantage. Their products and processes are becoming smarter. In India, we may not have seen so many acquisitions, but companies are already investing and acquiring stakes in digital companies. This is because the future lies in digital manufacturing. And when manufacturing OEMs start embracing such change, the ecosystem needs to follow to remain relevant, no doubt, in a judicious manner. Well, there are numerous advantages that Industry 4.0 is expected to drive. Its scope is very large, as it seeks to integrate manufacturing expertise horizontally as well as vertically. But some of the most popular advantages revolve around sensor-based automation, connectivity, and data analytics. Companies have achieved improvement in productivity, quality, equipment uptime, inventory management, safety, etc. When these get translated into financial outcomes, one starts seeing the significant importance of Industry 4.0. There are challenges as well in this journey. Let's look at the ground realities. As stated earlier, despite above benefits, manufacturers still have questions. One of the reasons is that the automation in the manufacturing companies is more dominant and prevalent in the larger organizations as opposed to the SMEs. Investment in automation is dependent on investment capacity and the opportunity to leverage it for positive business results. It is equally dependent on the tech expertise that is available in different organizations and one can take advantage of. On the other hand, technology companies too need to understand the issues manufacturing companies are facing, especially the SMEs. Then there are issues around the physical and emotional well-being of the people in these times of turbulence. Unless these insecurities and issues are addressed, mere technological upgrades will not bring about the desired change. And this is where Integrate plays a vital role. So let's talk about what Integrate really stands for. So Integrate was a term that was coined keeping in mind these eight focus areas, which form the essence of Industry 4.0, which are business shifts in terms of reorganizing and restructuring your businesses to align with the needs of the Industry 4.0. Technologies, which cover the evaluation and selection of the technologies that are aptly tailored and suited for your organization. Data analytics. As we know by now, the data is the foundation of Industry 4.0, and we need to ensure that this is used to its full potential. Connected systems, which involves convergence of IT and OT and taking the shop floor to the top floor. Talent readiness, which would need upskilling of our existing manpower, to learn and adopt to these new technologies. Innovation. Digitalization provides opportunities, but if you want to make your business truly smart and connected, innovation is a must in your products as well as your processes. And this needs to be leveraged to help in transforming your businesses positively. Safety and security of people, assets, and cyber safety are going to be critical in the Industry 4.0 environment, where not only organizations but also nations are facing a huge threat. Business processes. Aligning and revamping our conventional business processes in tune with the digital world is the key to successful implementation of Industry 4.0. So let's look at the benefits of Integrate India 2021. Integrate India was curated to meet multiple objectives. For instance, to demystify Industry 4.0 to the industries at large, especially the SMEs, as they are still in the initial stages of transformations and have a lot of ground to cover. The multiple dimensions and the complexity of industry is often overwhelming to the manufacturers who are not exposed to digital technologies. Simplifying the understanding is very crucial to drive away the doubts and apprehensions. To help companies to take on the journey of digital transformation, where they are required to develop their digital business strategies and build their capacities for execution. Bringing together the industry and technology companies on one platform to ensure that there is a holistic understanding. Post-implementation of Industry 4.0, the dominant outcomes are multifold and a lot of benefits that the companies will derive out of them. The top five which come to my mind are revenue growths, profitability growths, healthy cash flows, enhanced customer experience, and compliances. So we're focusing on the business and human dimension of Industry 4.0 in this particular conference, and not only the technology. Therefore, we are giving you a 360-degree view on what matters the most in this domain. How are we planning on doing this? Well, the first step before embarking on any change is to become aware of the changes that have taken place. Most often, we get too engrossed in daily operations, not having the time to scan the environment and think about its impact. It is also true not everyone has access to the needed resources, which can give them credible and relevant information. So, we're getting to you more than 30 speakers from diverse domains, including global leaders with rich international manufacturing experience. Different dimensions will be put forth by stalwarts with different perspectives from real stories and use cases that they've come across. Practical tips on implementations will be given by them to make India a global player and a smart manufacturing hub. What lies beyond Integrate India 2021? Let us accept the fact that in this changing world, organizations need to embrace Industry 4.0 solutions to be successful and also enable India to be a global manufacturing hub. So we have made a beginning in this direction, and surely this is not the end. As a result, we do not want to make this conference a one-time event. It is our vision to enable you in this journey. Industry 4.0 is not a trivial change. It is an ecosystem one. So a dialogue needs to continue. Post the event, we also plan to publish information about Industry 4.0 that would be helpful to our members. We will also be on the lookout for specific digital manufacturing business opportunities for our members. In conclusion, I hope and wish that each one of you makes the most out of this conference, which is a result of months of hard work and collaboration from all of us at ISCC. This is our team who put together this event and drove it from concept to execution. I thank each and every one of them. But you all must be asking yourselves, what is Industry 4.0? Industry 4.0 is a term that originated in Germany, as we all know, and it denotes the fourth industrial revolution, which aims at a connected value chain in manufacturing that is personalized, smart, and intelligent. The fourth industrial revolution is radically changing the way we work and live. The cascading impact of this revolution is that the manufacturing techniques are undergoing major and rapid shifts globally. And whether you like it or not, all of us have to make this transition. Let me explain to you what are the technological pillars on which Industry 4.0 rests. As we all know, these are some of them and there are many more, like machine-to-machine learning, 3D printing, cloud computing, Internet of Things, RFID solutions for real-time tracking of your goods, to high-level simulations to avoid any manufacturing defect. So why should we implement Industry 4.0? The clear signal today is that the world of manufacturing and digital technology are fast converging. Let us look at some of the examples. In the Western world, we see companies such as GE, Siemens, General Motors have acquired software companies to enhance their digital advantage. Their products and processes are becoming smarter. In India, we may not have seen so many acquisitions, but companies are already investing and acquiring stakes in digital companies. This is because the future lies in digital manufacturing. And when manufacturing OEMs start embracing such change, the ecosystem needs to follow to remain relevant, no doubt, in a judicious manner. Well, there are numerous advantages that Industry 4.0 is expected to drive. Its scope is very large, as it seeks to integrate manufacturing expertise horizontally as well as vertically. But some of the most popular advantages revolve around sensor-based automation, connectivity, and data analytics. Companies have achieved improvement in productivity, quality, equipment uptime, inventory management, safety, etc. When these get translated into financial outcomes, one starts seeing the significant importance of Industry 4.0. But there are challenges as well in this journey. Let's look at the ground realities. As stated earlier, despite above benefits, manufacturers still have questions. One of the reasons is that the automation in the manufacturing companies is more dominant and prevalent in the larger organizations as opposed to the SMEs. Investment in automation is dependent on investment capacity and the opportunity to leverage it for positive business results. It is equally dependent on the tech expertise that is available in different organizations and one can take advantage of. On the other hand, technology companies too need to understand the issues manufacturing companies are facing, especially the SMEs. Then there are issues around the physical and emotional well-being of the people in these times of turbulence. Unless these insecurities and issues are addressed, mere technological upgrades will not bring about the desired change. And this is where Integrate plays a vital role. So let's talk about what Integrate really stands for. So Integrate was a term that was coined keeping in mind these eight focus areas, which form the essence of Industry 4.0, which are business shifts in terms of reorganizing and restructuring your businesses to align with the needs of the Industry 4.0, technologies, which cover the evaluation and selection of the technologies that are aptly tailored and suited for your organization, data analytics. As we know by now, the data is the foundation of Industry 4.0, and we need to ensure that this is used to its full potential. Connected systems, which involves convergence of IT and OT and taking the shop floor to the top floor. Talent readiness, which would need upskilling of our existing manpower to learn and adopt to these new technologies. Innovation. Digitalization provides opportunities, but if you want to make your business truly smart and connected, innovation is a must in your products as well as your processes. And this needs to be leveraged to help in transforming your businesses positively. Safety and security of people, assets, and cyber safety are going to be critical in the Industry 4.0 environment, where not only organizations, but also nations are facing a huge threat. Business processes. Aligning and revamping our conventional business processes in tune with the digital world is the key to successful implementation of Industry 4.0. So let's look at the benefits of Integrate India 2021. Integrate India was curated to meet multiple objectives. For instance, to demystify Industry 4.0 to the industries at large, especially the SMEs, as they're still in the initial stages of transformations and have a lot of ground to cover. The multiple dimensions and the complexity of industry is often overwhelming to the manufacturers who are not exposed to digital technologies. Simplifying the understanding is very crucial to drive away the doubts and apprehensions. To help companies to take on the journey of digital transformation, where they are required to develop their digital business strategies and build their capacities for execution. Bringing together the industry and technology companies on one platform to ensure that there is a holistic understanding. Post-implementation of Industry 4.0, the dominant outcomes are multifold and a lot of benefits that the companies will derive out of them. The top five which come to my mind are revenue growth, profitability growth, healthy cash flows, enhanced customer experience, and compliances. So we're focusing on the business and human dimension of Industry 4.0 in this particular conference, and not only the technology. Therefore, we are giving you a 360-degree view on what matters the most in this domain. How are we planning on doing this? Well, the first step before embarking on any change is to become aware of the changes that have taken place. Most often, we get too engrossed in daily operations, not having the time to scan the environment and think about its impact. It is also true not everyone has access to the needed resources, which can give them credible and relevant information. So, we're getting to you more than 30 speakers from diverse domains, including global leaders with rich international manufacturing experience. Different dimensions will be put forth by stalwarts with different perspectives from real stories and use cases that they've come across. Practical tips on implementations will be given by them to make India a global player and a smart manufacturing hub. What lies beyond Integrate India 2021? Let us accept the fact that in this changing world, organizations need to embrace Industry 4.0 solutions to be successful and also enable India to be a global manufacturing hub. So we have made a beginning in this direction, and surely this is not the end. As a result, we do not want to make this conference a one-time event. It is our vision to enable you in this journey. Industry 4.0 is not a trivial change. It is an ecosystem one. So a dialogue needs to continue. Post the event, we also plan to publish information about Industry 4.0 that would be helpful to our members. We will also be on the lookout for specific digital manufacturing business opportunities for our members. In conclusion, I hope and wish that each one of you makes the most out of this conference, which is a result of months of hard work and collaboration from all of us at ISCC. This is our team who put together this event and drove it from concept to execution. I thank each and every one of them. Finally, as the chairperson of the Indo-American Chamber of Commerce, Pune, once again, I welcome you all to this impactful conference and exhibition, and may these power-packed upcoming 3 days be filled with immense learning, new business ventures, technological advancements, innovations, and above all, long-term partnerships. I thank all our eminent speakers for their valuable contribution to this event, and all of you for taking time off your busy schedules and joining us to witness the most significant conference in recent times. And last but not the least, let's integrate ourselves with this world of digital transformation. Thank you very much and welcome once again.
Thank you, Rujita, for all your support. And we'll move on to the next session, which will start after the video break. But in the meantime, please do look at the updated schedule on the microsite. There have been a few changes because of COVID, so the schedule has been adjusted. And don't forget to take some photos in the IACC Integrate photo booth in the lobby. See you after the break.